In this video, I'm going to show you how to use the Cutco boning knife. Some of the features that I love about the boning knife that makes it very, very special is that it has this long, almost 7-inch straight blade that makes it perfect for going through meat. It's not a little bit better, but significantly better than the Cutco trimmer or the Cutco petite carver. And I'll show you how and why here. Now, if you're like my family and most families across America, you're not buying the huge whole chickens like they used to, or like what mom or grandma used to do. For most people, it's gonna be your simple boneless, skinless chicken breasts. Now, a lot of people like to use something like the trimmer to go through the chicken breasts. Now, why would we need to go through this? It's pretty much mostly prepared. Well, at my house, we really don't like any of these fat niblets. So with that boning knife, it's really simple to just go in and just do any type of cleanup work on visible joints, blood veins, anything like that. Also, if you happen to get any of these rather large chicken breasts, it wasn't always like this. People used to get chicken breasts that were maybe half to a quarter of this size, but now that we know how to grow chickens that are gigantic like this, sometimes it's a little bit easier to cut these up so that they grill or bake a little bit faster. Doesn't get a whole lot better than with the boning knife. Now with this piece, it's a great item to just kind of bring inside of your chicken breast about halfway through. Just place your hand on top and just making some sliding motions to make an initial cut. You can open it up and just keep sliding along here until you feel comfortable. To open it up like this is how to butterfly, or to go all the way through. Now you've got two simple, easier chicken breasts that will actually cook twice as fast. If you're doing something like a stir fry or fajita, this makes quick and easy work while the chicken is still raw to cut into slices or even cubes. Now compare this to something like the Cutco trimmer, where it's actually going to be significantly harder to go through here. So I can still go through here and compare that to the ease of the boning knife. For all of your raw meat prepping needs, use the boning knife. I hope you got some value out of this video. If you did, hit the like and subscribe button, share it with your friends. We'll see you in the next video. And I'd love to also see what your favorite things to do with the boning knife are. What questions do you still have unanswered? And what other knives would you like to hear about? We look forward to seeing your comments in the comment section below. And remember, it's not the food that you make that matters most, it's who you share it with.